Just a quick update, I've never done one for quite some time. Just to show you how the tank has changed. Different corals in the tank and aquascapes changed. I think for the better. Mainly softies and zoas. LPS and all, yeah. Just getting this piece at the weekends. Lovely piece, that. So I'm really liking the tank. Got a huge Nazo tank. As you can see by streamers at the back, he's a male. I also have a smaller Nazo tank. Still got the purple tan, and I've still got three yellow tans. If I had a bigger tank, I would add more yellow tans. I love the yellow tans. Constantly grazing. I also got a new fish, which you haven't seen, the clown tan. He's not that big at the present time, but can be a little bit aggressive. Even towards the big nozzle tank there, nozzle tank. But it's more of a hindrance to him, like a little kid kicking at your heels. But I'll keep an eye on it as he gets bigger. It's a beautiful fish. I say I've had him for probably 3 months, a bit longer. The first 6 weeks, believe it or not, he didn't eat one piece of frozen food, any nori, no food whatsoever. He only survived on grazing on the rocks and the algae on the back of the tank. I did think I was going to lose him with not eating so long. I didn't think he would have survived so long, but he did from the natural resources in the tank. But he's now eaten everything now, so he's put the weight on. Some nice coloured zoanthids there now, yeah. Some mushrooms, and I've just added a few SPS. I did lose all my SPS over a year ago, so I sworn I wouldn't keep any more, but the tank's more matured now and more stable, so I'm just giving it a go with these pieces, see how it goes. That's why I've kept this area here for SPS corals, high flow area, top of the rock there and things. But I'm just trying it out first of all with these two pieces, see how it goes. This toadstool is a very strange one. It opens up for 2 days and closes for 5. I got up this morning, I thought it was dead. Didn't look happy whatsoever. And 2 hours later, it's picture of health. So it's got me bamboozled this toadstool. So that's the same hammer coral there. I've had that now for a couple of years. Doing absolutely awesome. Grown by the month, that one. And again, the rest of the fish and corals are doing okay. These zoanthids have grown like weeds, so I've got them separated from this area here. Yeah. Quick look under the sump, I'll show you. Not much change under there. I do have a reactor on there, which is raw phos and carbon. Same skimmer, let's see. There's the flow coming out of the reactor. The reactor comes from the chiller, the UV, and it's returned to the return pump. I did change the return pump from Red Sea. Just so I could have a spare one. Forgetting what the pump's called offhand now, but it's a real good one. It'll come to us shortly. It's quite a big one. And there actually it is, that's the controller for the pump. DC. So you can adjust the flow, you can put it on feed mode. So it's nice and quiet pumping off. So I put the Red Sea one away, cleaned it as a spare. I am going to be upgrading the flow pumps to the quiet drive. For anybody that doesn't know, I took the Red Sea lights off and all, and I've replaced them with 3 Radiant. So I'm quite pleased at the minute. Everything's doing well. Like in the aquascape. Dear view down there. I always keep the back of the tank clear to help with the flow. See how clean the gravel's looking. So everything's doing well. So this is just a quick update for anybody that's interested in how the tank is getting on. See the water quality is quite good. Phosphates is 0.02, nitrate 0.01, and calcium and magnesium, that went, you're all sitting very, very good and all, yeah. What did happen though, just before I go, is you see I've had these tangs all in the tank for a long time, the yellow tangs and the purple tang. Then out of the blue, after a couple of years of all getting on together, they've decided, all three of them, that didn't want this purple tang in the tank. They really chased it really hard for 3 or 4 days, constantly battering it. Did pull through, but the purple tang doesn't really leave this area of the tank. If it stays in this area, the yellow tangs leave it alone. If it comes out, then they'll normally chase it back in the corner. I did try and catch a purple tang as this was happening, so I could give them a safe haven in the sun for a bit, or even return them to the aquatic shop. But I didn't manage to catch it, but everything seems to have calmed right down compared to where it was. And the purple tang recovered, and it's looking in good health again. During this time, it still remained eaten. But as it was coming out for the food, it had to rain on the gauntlet. So this is just a quick update. Thumbs up if you want to see more videos. Obviously if I don't get a thumbs up, then I know people aren't really interested. So I just follow other people's channels. Just for anybody that's interested, thanks for watching.